Welcome back to Grief Inspired. My name is Catherine McNulty, and here we talk about all things relating to loss of a loved one. And I focus primarily on giving you hope, hope for the heartbroken, and getting you to a place where you can find your path to happiness after loss. Now, today we're going to be talking about guilt. Guilt is such a big concept that so many of us feel as part of our grief process. And so I'm going to give you three steps today to help you process, work through, and release your guilt. So stay tuned. You're not going to want to miss it. Welcome back. So today we're going to be talking about guilt. You probably know what guilt is, but guilt is the feeling that you have. It is an emotion. It is a feeling that you have that's very remorseful. There are things that maybe you wish you had done, or there would be things that you wish you hadn't done that you can feel guilty about. And guilt is a feeling that we don't like. It's very uncomfortable when we feel intensely guilty. We tend to use that guilt and internalize it and use it as an opportunity to feel bad about ourselves. So there's a whole conversation around guilt that we can have that says, well, you can feel guilty, but not necessarily beat yourself up for it. But we're not going to talk about that today. We're going to talk about what can you do? What's the process to help you release your guilt? So there's basically three steps when it comes to processing and releasing your guilt. The first step is to identify what you feel guilty about. So one or two weeks of the grief course that I run, we spend on guilt because guilt is such a big topic. And so the first thing that we do prior to the course in leading up to the specific class on guilt is to say, what do I feel guilty about? So I typically suggest that you write down this phrase, I feel guilty that. And then you spend 30 minutes or so thinking about your loss and thinking about all the things that you feel guilty about. And these are gonna be the things that you wish you had done, the things that you didn't do, or maybe it's the things that you did do and you wish that you hadn't done. So you want to write them down and you want to get very clear on what it is that you feel guilty about. And what I typically recommend is once you have your list, then prioritize it. There are typically things that are the big ones, the things that really hold us back. And if we can identify what those are, then we can work through them and we can really just feel generally better and move toward accepting the loss and everything that's happened. The second step is once you have identified what it is that you feel guilty about, the question becomes, well, why do you feel guilty? Really spending time understanding what makes you feel guilty about whatever happened. So some people, for example, will say, I feel guilty that I didn't take my mother's illness more seriously. I feel guilty that I didn't take them to the doctor sooner. I feel guilty that we had words, that my last words with this person were not positive words. There's so many things that we can feel guilty about. And so identifying what they are was step one, and step two was really exploring, well, why do you feel guilty? What is it about what happened that makes you feel guilty? What do you wish you had done? What do you wish you hadn't done? How do you wish things had been different? So getting really clear on what that is and knowing what those things are is really gonna help. So then that brings us to step three. Once you know what you're feeling guilty about and why you really feel guilty, then the next step is to shift your perspective. And this is where the work starts. So what I want you to do is you have written down your phrase, I feel guilty that, whatever it is. And then I want you to step outside of yourself and imagine that it isn't you who's feeling guilty. It's your best friend or your brother or your sister who's feeling guilty. And I want that you to imagine them telling you that they feel guilty the same way that you do. And then I want you to think about that and say, if they were telling me how guilty they felt, what advice would I give them? What would I say back to them? So let's take an example. If a friend of mine were to say, I feel guilty that I didn't take my wife's illness seriously enough. If I had taken her to the doctor, maybe she would still be okay. So I feel guilty that I didn't take her to the doctor sooner. I feel guilty that I didn't take her illness seriously enough, and look at the situation we're in. Well, if I'm telling that to myself, if I am the one who's feeling guilty because of my spouse, I would be much harder on myself. If I were saying it to someone else who is sharing this with me, I would say, well, first of all, you're not a doctor. You didn't know the seriousness of the illness. You didn't have a lot of time, right? Based on what the situation that they were in, and that I know how much you loved your spouse. I know that your intent was not to do anything to harm them, that if you knew it was much more serious, you absolutely would have taken it more seriously, been in more action. I can say all of these things. And sometimes it's easier to say these things to a friend rather than to say them to yourself. And when you've said them to a friend, you can then say them back to yourself. And you can look at it and talk to yourself the way you would talk to a friend. To be able to say, yes, I feel guilty. Maybe I did screw up, but I love this person. I cared about them. Had I known the situation differently, I would have done something differently. They knew how much I love them. I know how much they loved me. And I also know that me staying in this guilt, feeling guilty, beating myself up, is really not productive. So sometimes you want to ask yourself, is what you're doing, is it helping you or is it hurting you? Is it helping you process your emotions? Feeling guilty and going through that feelings of guilt and remorse, there's at times there's value in that, particularly early on, because we need to go through that process. But if you are hanging on to your guilt and repeatedly beating yourself up about it and reliving it over and over and over again, ask yourself the question, is this productive? Is it making me a better person? Sometimes we can learn from our guilt and say, well, okay, now I know. Can we learn from our guilt? Is it productive? Is it helping you or is it hurting you? If your guilt is hurting you, it's time to let it go. It's time to work these steps. Identify what you feel guilty about. Explore why you feel guilty. And it's taking time to do that exploration. And then it's shifting your perspective and saying, if this were my friend, if this were someone else that I was talking to about guilt, what would I say to them? At the end of the day, releasing guilt is about forgiving yourself. It's about loving yourself. It's about sometimes giving yourself grace and being able to say, well, I did the best I could with the information I had at the time when I was making the decision. Do not forget, hindsight is always 20/20. It is so easy to look back on our guilt and say, I should have done this. To look back on what happened and say, I definitely should not have done that. It's easy to do in hindsight. But remember, the things that we're making our decisions on, we don't necessarily have all the information. We have limited information. So when we can tell ourselves, I did the best I could with the information I had and the position that I was in with what I knew, that's the opportunity to release your guilt. So I hope these three steps have helped you. Please drop a comment below. Do not forget to subscribe to my channel. And as always, reach out to me at griefinspired@gmail.com and let's get the conversation going and let's get you the hope that you need to find your path to happiness so that you can release that heartbroken feeling. Bye for now.